Before talking about VLANs, let's start by understanding what a LAN is. A LAN, for local area network, is a network that covers a limited geographical area, such as a building, a house, a hospital, or a school. The most popular type of LAN is Ethernet LAN. In this example, within this small company, there is a local network where several work computers share network file servers and printers. In a LAN, all machines can communicate with each other. They are said to be in the same broadcast domain. However, here, we want to have a dedicated local network with machines reserved for the marketing team and another one with machines for salespeople. That's why we need VLANs. A VLAN, for Virtual Local Area Network, is a virtual local network, allowing you to divide a single physical network into multiple logical networks, all on the same switch. As a reminder, a switch connects multiple machines within the same local network. This means you can create multiple LANs on a single physical infrastructure, each with its own broadcast domain. Here, the two VLANs allow separating devices according to departments, even though both are physically connected to the same network. It's like having multiple switches within one switch. VLANs allow dividing this enterprise network into distinct logical segments. To do this, you need to configure each port of the switch, called access ports, to be part of a VLAN. Thus, an access port can only be in one VLAN at a time. VLANs per port associate a switch port with a VLAN. Here, all machines using ports in yellow are part of VLAN 1, and those with ports in blue are part of VLAN 2. But why VLANs are so popular? Firstly, VLANs optimize network performance. VLANs reduce the size of broadcast domains since only devices belonging to the same VLAN share this traffic. No unnecessary broadcasting, which improves response time and reduces latency. VLANs contribute to strengthening network security by logically grouping resources according to security requirements. This limits access to VLAN resources since each VLAN operates as an independent entity. Secondly, VLANs reduce infrastructure costs because you use the same physical network to transmit information from multiple logical networks and therefore use the same network equipment. This means less spending. Finally, VLANs provide flexibility in network management because you can modify VLAN configurations. For example, adding or removing VLANs as needed, all without having to rewire the network. Now let's talk about trunk links, which are connections between multiple switches. The goal is to carry multiple VLANs over a single physical connection. This allows connecting VLANs between different devices while maintaining VLAN separation. Ports that carry multiple VLANs at once are called trunk ports. On these ports, the switch adds a header to the Ethernet frame to identify which VLAN the frame comes from. This header contains several data, but for VLANs it contains the most important, the VLAN tag. These VLAN tags, added to data packets, indicate which virtual network they belong to. Switches read these tags and forward data packets to the correct VLAN. However, to allow devices in different VLANs to communicate with each other, inter-VLAN routing is required. Here, we see that a device in VLAN 1 can access a resource in VLAN 2 by passing through a router. This routing is feasible with a Layer 3 device of the OSI model. So, either a router, which traditionally has this role, as here, or via a Layer 3 switch. If the difference between a router and a switch is not clear to you, or if the mention of the OSI model's Layer 3 makes you puzzled, I strongly recommend watching my video on the OSI model. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you found it informative and insightful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to stay updated on my latest content and upcoming videos.